B and T cell activation can be simplified on the basis of various cell surface markers. Let's begin by discussing T cell activation. Classic antigen-presenting cells include macrophages, dendritic cells, and B cells. Remember that there are two signals required for both B and T cell activation. For T cell activation, a foreign body is phagocytized by the antigen-presenting cell and presented to the T cell via MHC2. This is signal 1. So what happens next? B7 on the antigen-presenting cell interacts with CD28. CD28 is on the T cell and acts as the co-stimulatory factor. This is signal number 2. After both signals are received, helper T cells are able to secrete cytokines, while cytotoxic T cells are able to destroy infected cells in order to control replication. B cell class switching also requires two signals. Similar to the T cell, we have an antigen that has already been processed by a T cell, which now presents the antigen to a B cell. This is signal 1. So what is signal number 2? The interaction between CD40 receptor on the B cells and the CD40 ligand on the T helper cells. Once this second signal has been received, the T cells secrete cytokines that will determine the antibody isotype to which B cells switch, such as IgEs, IgAs, and IgGs. Flash quiz time! What do B cells synthesize and release? Antibodies.